Joining me is Australia's top writer on foreign affairs, Greg Sheridan, the Australian newspaper. Great to be joined by you, Greg. I'm in a little bit of apprehension here because I've no idea whether you're going to share my opinion here or whether you're going to give me a dressing down. But Donald Trump says General Mark Milley promising to give China a heads up if the US was going to attack it. I mean, how can that not be called treason?
Well, Andrew, as you know, I've often written that I think you're the bravest man in Australia, and my admiration for you is legion and endless. Legion and endless. And that's not fake news. That's true. I think Milley has behaved responsibly here. If Trump really wanted, first of all, America doesn't do surprise attacks like Pearl Harbor. It declares war on people first and then attacks them. Second of all, if Trump ordered an attack on China and Milley said, no, I'm in the chain of command, you can't do that, Trump could sack Milley. Milley would be sacked. Trump could restate the order and the order would be carried out. So the most that Milley could do is delay things for maybe 24 hours. But Trump was really wildly erratic. Now, you know, Andrew, I started in 2016 as a never-Trumper, but he was a better president than I thought he would be. And by 2020, I wrote columns saying, on balance, he's a less bad choice than Biden. There's good about him and there's bad about him. I think his behaviour after the election was truly appalling and very frightening. And he demonised people like Mike Pence, the vice president, because he wouldn't overturn Congress's ratification of the Electoral College votes. He demonised and sacked people like the Defence Secretary, Mark Esper, who had been models of supine loyalty to him at every point, but just found there were certain points beyond which they could not go. Now, I think the presence of responsible people right throughout the American system, even if they're Trump supporters, is a good and reassuring thing. Milley may not be the greatest bloke in the world, but I think for him simply to say, the president seems very unstable. If there's an order for military action, it has to go through me as the top soldier. I think that is actually, I'm glad that he did that.
Well, let me put my counterpoint here and see whether you can knock that over. First of all, I agree with you on the first phone call. Don't worry, General. It looks all untidy. It's the American system. Fine, it'll be okay. That's fine. But he then decides, and I don't think there is a reason for deciding this, that Donald Trump could launch an attack on China just to, stay president. I think that's just absurd. I mean, I agree with you. He behaved appallingly. I said it at the time, behaved appallingly, erratically, irrationally. But this is a man who's been boasting that he's the first president since I don't know when, never to go to war. I don't think it's going to create World War III with China just to get a few days more. And as for Milley resigning, well, he could have resigned. That was the proper thing to do. It's not his role to tip off China to a lawful direction from the president. He can resign at the time, and resigning would send China a signal, and I doubt that the man replacing him would give the order to attack either. I think it'd be a cascading number of resignations if that absurd scenario had ever existed. I think he acted above his station and undemocratically. That's my opinion. But tell me what I'm missing in this picture.
No, I think you could be right on the second call, Andrew. So you and I also suffer this disadvantage. The story has just come out. We're paid to make an instant judgment on it, and that's what we should do. But we'll get more facts in time. Woodward is generally a reasonably reliable chronicler. I've read all of his books except the Supreme Court book, and he was actually much more balanced and sensible about Trump than any of the other people. Also, his sources are very transparent. He tells you what his source had for breakfast and said to his wife the night before and so on. It's very clear who his sources are. I'll be interested to read the whole book. It may well be, you could well be right here, Andrew. I wouldn't, in the granular detail, I wouldn't necessarily disagree with you. I suspect, however, that Milley didn't actually tip the Chinese off. What he's done is just reassure them, don't misinterpret anything. Now, I did have my own independent sources into the Trump, camp after the election, and Trump was behaving in a very unstable fashion, and he was willing to take any action. I agree with you. I don't think he was going to launch nuclear war. I agree with you. But of course, a general is poised to cope with something which goes from being a 0% possibility to a 1% possibility. Now, if the burden of Milley's phone call is to say to the Chinese, let's not go to war by accident. Don't misinterpret an exercise we're having in the South China Sea as an attack on you. I promise you this is not what's happening. I think that's kind of okay. But maybe he did overstep the mark. I want to see all the detail about it, you know.
No, look, all that's true. And, you know, even Trump is wondering whether the general has been fairly reported here. So we shall see. We shall see. But if this is what he said, I think that crosses the line. And I wonder, Greg, if the Chinese general would return the favour and ever tip off General Milley if China's dictator had ordered him to attack America. And I don't know that this is now an idle threat, with China threatening to invade Taiwan and picking fights with all sorts of countries. In fact, I look at the five most popular stories today on the website of the Global Times, which is one of the Chinese dictatorship's official newspapers, and all of it sounds like the ravings of a dictatorship getting ready for war. From the top story, four PLA ships, army ships, or military ships from China sent to sail off Alaska, you know, to send the US a confronting message. Why the US is afraid of war with China? A warning to Japan's ruling LDP party not to bash China, an attack on Australia for banning an academic on national security grounds, and then a video warning the US, and this is a warning from the Global Times boss himself, not to recognise Taiwan as an independent nation or else. Have a listen.
Beijing will definitely take economic and military actions against the arrogance of the US and Taiwan.
Greg, I haven't seen such a litany of warnings from a belligerent dictatorship since, 1939. What's going on here?
Well, I think you're right, Andrew. I think this is extremely disturbing. And, of course, there is a great contrast between China and America, and there should be. I mean, Japan essentially did a surprise attack on America at Pearl Harbor. That's against the rules of war. You know, war has rules. There's a just war theory in Christian theology. War has rules. America doesn't do that. America decided to take action to stop Iraq from invading Kuwait. It told Iraq what it was going to do. It built up its troops publicly and so on. And we rely on American stability and predictability. When America is unstable, I think Trump did a lot of good things, but he also introduced a terrible unpredictability and weirdness into American national life. I think Biden is terribly weak and is unpredictable in his own way. The whole world relies on American predictability. But at the same time, this is even more the case now that we're seeing such bellicosity from the Chinese. Did you see the Chinese banning effeminate men from their TV screens, insisting insisting that schools have to teach Xi Jinping thought. I mean, they're like, China now is like the old Roman Empire. The Xi Jinping has become, in effect, a state deity. He's been, so, you know, Christian churches and Buddhist temples have to have pictures of Xi Jinping and acknowledge him as the head of their church, even though communism is officially atheist. This extremely bellicose talk all the time, it's very dangerous. They may well be tempted to attack Taiwan and think that Biden is so weak that that they wouldn't respond. I think, it's in our interest. Whoever is the president, whether it's Trump or it's Biden, I want them to succeed. And it's in our interest that America be strong and predictable. I want the Chinese to be scared of what the Americans would do if they cross a line. And at the moment, I'm not sure that that's the case.
I think we're living in very dangerous times, Greg. I'm so glad that Australia is playing a really active role in trying to get an alliance of countries around China to focus on unity in the face of this aggression. Let's hope it all pays off. Greg Sheridan, thank you so much for your time.